beyond the mountains green, no stain yet on the moon was seen. No words were laid on stream or stone when Durin woke and walked alone.
He named the nameless hills and dells. He drank from yet untasted wells.
He stooped and looked in mirror me.
Gems upon a silver thread above the shadows of his head.
The world was fair, the mountains tall, in elder days before the fall
of mighty kings in Argos throned and Gondor. He was on carven throne in many pillared halls of stone with golden roof and silver floor and runes of power upon the door. The light of sun and star and moon in shining lamps of crystal gold and in it by cloud or shade of night, there shone forever fair and bright.
The hammer on the anvil smote, the chisel clove and graver rolled, the forged was blade and bound was hilt,
the delver mined, the mason.
The barrel, pearl, and opal pale, and metal wrought like fish's mail, buckler and course that axe and sword and shining spears will pay in war.
Unwearied then were to mountains music walk.
The harpers harped, the minstrels sang, and at the gates the trumpets rang. The world is grey, the mountains old, the forge's fire is ashen cold. No harp is drum, no hammer falls, the darkness dwells in Durin's halls. The shadow lies upon his tomb, in Moria, in Khazad-dûm. But still the sunken stars appear.